I know. shall we gather at the river, where bright angel feet have trod, with its crystal tide forever flowing by the throne of God. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful, beautiful river. We'll gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God. Soon we'll reach the shining river. Soon our pilgrimage will cease. Soon our happy hearts will quiver with the melody of peace. And yes, we'll gather at the river, beautiful, beautiful.
Please be seated. We have come to this place where sadness fills our hearts, but we give thanks for Gail and for her life. We have come to feel the comfort of others who share in our grief, where good memories can flood our minds. We rejoice that God's love is here, now and forever. And a thank you to the family for allowing me to offer the opportunity to offer some words of comfort at this time. And for those who are joining for the live stream, welcome. At this time, I'd like to invite Donna forward to share greetings.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Donna. I'm married to Darren. On behalf of the Clark and Trimble family, I would like to take the time to thank everyone who has cared or been a part of Mom's time here on Earth, a memorable one. Pardon me. Brian, I want to thank you for taking such good care of Mom. We could have not done it without you, and it means a lot to us. I would like to read Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 to 31. At the time, Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." I had the honor of being with Mom when she passed away peacefully, and I believe that this is what Mom felt at that time. "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light." So, Mom, we love you and we miss you dearly already. Rest in peace till we meet again.
Thank you, Donna. I found a poem that I'd like to share that I think is quite appropriate for our opening. With a constant chorus of cydias, the leaves tumble down. From long, thin silver poplars, they twirl to the ground, dancing the autumn death dance beneath the great blue sky. The leaves seem glad to be going. Is there something I don't know? Sparkling in the October sunshine, they fill the air with gentle rustling. One, then another and another. On they skim down from above, bedding the forest table before me with the comforting crunches and crackles. This gigantic death scene of leaves does not smell of sorrow and sadness. Rather, the earth is colored with joy and the leaves make music in the wind. Why is this dance of death so lovely? Why do the leaves seem so willing to go? Are they whispering to each other, urging one another to be freed? Maybe you first, and then I'll follow. Or you can do it. Go ahead, supporting one another gladly in their call to final surrender. I have not yet discovered the secret of the serenity of sailing leaves. Every autumn, I walk among them with a longing that stretches forever, wanting to face that death dance and the truth of my own mortality. That was by Joyce Rupp. Grace to you and comfort in the name of God our Maker, who knows the count of hairs on our heads and the days of our lives. In the name of Jesus, our brother and friend, who has journeyed on all our roads with us, and in the warm embrace of the Spirit of life, whose care surrounds us always. If you'd join with me in prayer. Creator, Spirit of life, you have shared with us the life of Gail, and it is with grateful hearts we give thanks for all the goodness in her, which now lives and grows in us and others. And now we honor her life and say goodbye. We seek to find comfort in our loneliness, allow forgiveness where it may be needed, and gain courage to face the future unafraid. Strengthen and draw us closer to one another. Enable us to serve and give to us that sense of peace and joy that comes from knowing that we are connected in life and beyond this life. Amen. And now I'd like to invite Charissa forward to share the memories.
Hi. On behalf of my family, I would like to begin by thanking everyone who is here today and for those who have sent their condolences. We have received numerous phone calls, texts, meals, visits, and thoughts and prayers, and they have been both comforting during this difficult time and have been a reminder of how special Grandma Gail was to those who knew her. My name is Charissa, and I am Gail's granddaughter. I want to tell you a little bit about my grandma and to honor the special memories my family has of her. Grandma was the oldest of seven kids, born and raised on a farm just outside of Marshall. She married young and started her family in the small town of Lone Rock. She raised three kids here, my Uncle Dave, my dad Darren, and my Auntie Doreen. She was active in the community and belonged to many community groups. She enjoyed sewing, knitting, and crocheting. Summers were filled with camping, gardening, fishing, and hopefully cleaning enough fish for belly stuffing fish fry. As the kids grew up, there was more opportunities to travel, which she enjoyed, and she was able to visit places like Scotland and Louisiana. She also continued to knit and sew for each of the grandchildren and babies born into the family. Grandchildren were gifted with baby blankets, knit sweaters, quilos, and afghans. After marrying Brian, she continued to be able to travel and visited Hawaii, Mexico, and Disneyland. They also did cruises to Alaska and the Panama Canal. Now I would like to share some of the favorite memories my family has of my grandma. My Uncle Dave's favorite memory is of the time Grandma was learning to drive the Ski-Doo and headed down to the farm with Uncle Dave on the back. He remembers being about 13 at the time and maybe a little too cool to hang on. Although Grandma wasn't going all that fast, when she hit a bump, Uncle Dave fell off and Grandma didn't notice and kept on going. It wasn't until she arrived at the farm and was asked where Dave was that she discovered she no longer had a passenger. My dad, Darren's favorite memory is a bread baking day. It was always a special treat to come home after school and find warm, fresh bread or buns and have a snack with butter and homemade jam. My Auntie Doreen's favorite memory is of a fishing trip about 10 years ago. Auntie Doreen and Uncle Dean joined Grandma and Brian at their cabin at Loon Lake for a weekend of fishing. The fish were biting like crazy, and they were able to take more than enough fish for a fish fry and some to freeze. Evenings were spent playing cards and sitting by the fire. Cabri loves the memories she has of looking through photo albums with Grandma and listening to her share history and family stories. My brother Braden's favorite memory is when he was quite young, Grandma would let the grandkids decorate the Christmas tree. She only helped when we couldn't reach high enough. It didn't look great, but she was okay with it and took pictures of it. He also remembers staying with her to go to school and how she would always pack lunches for him and made sure he actually made it to school. She really cared for all of us. My favorite memory of Grandma is her teaching me how to knit, or trying to teach me how to knit. She was so patient, even though I wasn't very good at it. That time with her was just very special. My grandma was a really special lady, a great wife, mother, sister, grandmother, great-grandmother, and a friend. Her love and kindness has touched all of us in different ways. Grandma, you will be missed greatly. I already know that you will always be with us, as you have loved us unconditionally. I am grateful that I had you in my life. We love you, Grandma. After the service, we're going to have some fellowship where we can all share some memories of Grandma Gail together. Thank you.
At this time, we are going to watch the slideshow so that everyone has the opportunity to remember.
Didn't know today would be your last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight.
The scripture that was chosen for the service today is Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 through 15. Very familiar to many, I'm sure. For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to tear and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. What gains have the workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He has made everything suitable for its time. Moreover, he has put a sense of past and future into their minds, yet they cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. I know that there is nothing better for them than to be happy and enjoy themselves as long as they live. Moreover, it's God's gift that all should eat and drink and take pleasure in their toil. I know that whatever God does endures forever. Nothing can be added to it, nor nothing taken from it. God has done this so that all should stand in awe before him. That which is already has been. That which is to be already is, and God seeks out what has gone by. Death is not something that we talk about often. We especially try to avoid the thought of our own final passage from this life to the next. It's scary and unpredictable. Yet every day of our lives, our bodies are aging. We rarely pay attention to this until that first real waning of energy, or the first gray hair and wrinkles, or until some significant part of our body refuses to function as it should. Sometimes we don't fear death until death itself as much as the dying process, with its potential for pain, incompetency, dependency, or mobility. We want to live. We want to be in control and have it all together. We are not ready to let go. Albert Schweitzer once wrote, "The main question in life is, how do you feel about death?" Everything that captivates us and engages us is only of relative and temporary worth. In an instant, in the very next hour, it may become utterly valueless. The reality of our mortality can certainly put all of life in quick perspective. Some people do not like autumn because it reminds them too much of the inevitability of death. The leaves falling from the trees onto the barren ground. Brown earth makes them feel sad and lonely. The leaves are subtle reminders that we are asked to let go of many things throughout our life. Every time we must surrender something, we connect with our death, with the ultimate moment of letting go. Autumn is an opportunity to reflect on and to claim this reality. Seeing death in any form, autumn leaves falling from the trees, or a loved one like Gail breathing their last breath of life, can call us face to face with the big questions of life. Who am I? Who have I become? What do I want to be? What do I truly value in life? What do I need to do with my time that remains? Who is significant in my life? Do I have unfinished business? These questions cause us to go deeper, to move beyond the surface issues of life. We struggle when we lose someone we love, and our hearts hurt. Although autumn might seem to be a harsh reminder of death, we can also be encouraged to enter into the mystery of eternal life. We see autumn standing in surrender as the winds sweep her trees naked. The frost browns her meadows and deadens her plants. But a deeper truth is beneath the appearance of death. A movement towards life takes place in the autumn. Dead leaves that seem to have no value are transformed by winter snow and spring rains into rich humus for new growth. The earth waits in the process of growth for the unknown, unseen beauty of another season. Autumn is a necessary transition between summer's fruitfulness and spring's new life. The dying of our physical body challenges our whole experience of life. Yet death is another form of birthing. We are birthed into eternal life. Gail's life here was filled with caring and kindness. She was a giving and cherished woman. She will be missed by all who loved her. All of our lives, God invites us to discover and accept who we are. All of our lives, we are called to live fully so that we will be ready to journey to the other side. When you leave here today, walk through the leaves and reflect on the reality of the season. Let go of whatever keeps you from growing. Accept the dying leaves in your life. Above all, celebrate the season of autumn, for its message has the power to ripen you for the final harvest. If you'd join with me in prayer. With the beat of your eternal time, you have been with us as we have today remembered Gail. We thank you for the life she had, all of its challenges, and all of the moments of wonder and fulfillment. We remember a wife, mother, someone who loved nature. We thank you for the memories that we have to savor for years to come. God of the living, God of those who have died, in life and in death, we are yours. We join our voices together, saying the prayer that Jesus has taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and glory, forever and ever. Amen. Take courage. Be confident and strong. Go where you must go. Do what you must do. Shed tears. Endure sorrow. Live with loneliness. But rejoice in memory. Comfort each other. But put your hope in the risen Christ, who leads us on through death to resurrection and to eternal joy. Oscar Romero said, "There are many things that can only be seen through eyes that have cried." And now may God keep us, our going out and our coming in, from this time forth and forevermore. May he hold you tenderly, wipe your tears, enable hope to be reborn in you, to heal your hearts with the blessing of love this day and forevermore. Amen. Our formal service is concluding now, and I'd like to invite all of Gail's grandchildren, if you so wish, you're welcome to come forward and take a flower from the wreath as a memento and a keepsake. After the service ends here, we will be going to the Legion for refreshments. If you're not sure where the Legion is, it's on 49th Street, up across from the theater. Just get in the line and follow. I think most people know where it is. If not, ask a friend. May God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he look upon you with kindness and give you peace. Amen.
Shall we gather at the river, where bright angel feet have trod, with its crystal tide forever flowing by the throne of God? Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful, beautiful river. We'll gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God. Soon we'll reach the shining river, soon our pilgrimage will cease, soon our happy hearts will quiver with the melody of peace. And yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful, beautiful gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God. Hey, Gordon, play one, man. On the margin of the river, washing up its silver spray, we will walk and worship ever all the happy golden day. And yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful, beautiful river, gather with the saints.